If we want to advance neuroscience, we need to map the brain. Our lab at MIT has been working on this for a while now, but it's going very slowly. It takes one of our researchers upwards of 50 hours to map one cell. Now that is one neuron, and there are over 80 billion in just one human brain. Each cell exhibits exquisite structure, kind of as you see here. It's quite a painstaking process. Our researchers have to manually trace the inside, branch by branch, and then stack these little bitty pieces together until we're able to reconstruct one entire cell. And by mapping neurons, there is a video on this slide. So anyway, by mapping neurons, let me just start that over because I know this is being recorded. By mapping neurons, we're able to understand how they process information, and this will help us unlock the keys to things like perception, the true neuroscience of learning, and things like how the brain miswires and mental disorders. But there simply are not enough neuroscientists in the world to make this happen. So we've opened it up. We've made this available to anyone, and now lots of people are doing it. 60,000 people from 100 countries are helping us discover how the brain works. Sebastian Sung's computational neuroscience lab at MIT has built EyeWire, a game to map the brain. Our new community, it's only 5 months old, has discovered numerous neural networks and complete cells that were previously unknown. Together, they're changing our fundamental understanding of the science of visual processing, and our top-scoring daily player is a 16-year-old from Bulgaria. Like, what? It's amazing. And over time, their actions in EyeWire are training advanced machine learning algorithms that will help automate the reconstruction of 3D objects from image data. And this is a revolution to the scientific method. And we have fun with this science. Actually, we host team-based competitions where we pit social networks against each other. Think Reddit versus Facebook in a battle to the death, you know, a battle to discover missing branches of neurons. But the team that wins the competition gets to name the cell that they discover. You know, that's leaving a legacy, right? You know, it's fun and it's important. Right now, people are discovering missing branches of these cells, but I think as we move forward, we'll figure out ways that we can strategically involve these brains from around the world, and people will be able to play a more fundamental role in determining how research actually moves forward. You know, it's important, and these gamers are helping our lab do work, and it's fun. And it's not just our lab. Labs around the world are kind of breaking out of academic isolation and engaging the general public in unprecedented approaches to the scientific method. We live in an amazing time. You know, you all have smartphones, we are all connected to the web, we have exponential computing power and clouds full of data. But this presents an interesting problem for researchers because they're limited in number and they only have so many hours, so we're barely able to skim the surface of a massive amount of data. But citizen science games are changing that. Foldit's gamers solve biomedical mysteries. NASA's citizen scientists, we call them stargazers, because they gaze into the heavens, right, and they discover new celestial bodies. And citizen science suites like Zooniverse provide platforms for researchers to develop and deploy crowdsourced games to massive multiplayer online communities. And this is only the beginning. It's estimated that people spend 3 billion hours every week playing online games. That's 342,000 years every week. That number is expected to grow to 21 billion by 2020. So imagine if researchers could harness a significant portion of this time and put these people's brain power to use, solving scientific challenges. If we could get 10 minutes a day from 10 million people, that would come to 66 years worth of full-time work every week. But it's not work. It's playing a game to advance the very forefront of science. You know, a part of making science popular is bringing it back, you know, making it a part of people's daily lives. Citizen science does that. You know, I think by playing even a small role in something so big as mapping the brain, really fosters a new kind of community around science. It builds those authentic connections. So what's next? Citizen scientists, you, hold the power to revolutionize scientific progress in ways that we can only begin to imagine. So help us out. Join the community. It is awesome. Thank you.